NAC is hosting Section 10's Battery Blocking Day. For the visiting Yellow Jackets, 0, Andy Ball. 0, PJ Gagnon. 1, Richard Wright. 3, Colin McNamara. 4, Austin Scott. 8, Zach Flanagan. 10, Jaron Harbor. 13, Jacob McNamara. 14, Brandon Wright. 15, James Hunt. 16, Kyle Bennett. 17, Jeff Mott. 18, Eric Squires. 20, Jimmy Miller. 21, Anthony Zeledon. 23, Alex Brock. Now tonight's starting lineup for the Mattern Washington Yellow Jackets. In goal, Matt Kendall. Number 2, Dan Gasada. Number 5, Colin O'Brien. Number 6, Josh Tiernan. Number 7, Zach Marcellus. Number 9, Ken Johnson. Number 11, Jacob Mayette. Number 12, Adam Zilney. Number 19, Brian Jackwith. Number 22, Terry Crump. And number 25, Jacob Barney. The Madrid Washington Yellow Jackets are coached by Gerhard Tischler. His assistants are Jesse Richards and Jeff Stein. Now for Section 7's NAC Bobcats. Ethan King. Number 14. Ray Spark. Number 15, Ryan Basil. Number 7, Jared Nichols. Number 5, Evan Nichols. Number 22, Colby Guerin. Now for the starting lineup for the NAC Bobcats. Number 11, Brandon Bowman. Number 9, Scott Collette. Number 2, Dylan LaBarge. Number 3, Ryan Andy. Number 13, Blake LaBarge. Number 1, Nolan Ferguson. Number 4, Justin Collette. Number 17, Shane Trudeau. Number 8, Ethan Musso. Number 10, Josh Radu. And number 6, David Miller. And coach is Peter Kowalski, his assistant are Pat Gordon and Justin Gardner. Tonight's officials are Mr. Randy Lozier, Mr. Barry Gordon, and Mr. Gary Kaiser. Thank you.
Calvin Cast On at the Plattsburgh High School Sports Complex. It's the 8th day of November, Election Day 2011, and we're here for Regional Soccer Section 7 going against Section 10. And the Madrid Waddington Yellow Jackets have invaded the home of the Hornets. And they'll be going against the Northern Adirondack Bobcats right here, right now on viewer-supported hometown cable. Action is underway. The Yellow Jackets in the blue with the yellow trim. Bobcats are in white. Their course colors are green and gold. Take us a while to figure out where the cats are out there. Won't be doing much of anything on the visitors. So trying just to keep track of where the Bobcats are. We're hoping one of our play-by-play men could make it here tonight, but didn't work out that way, so we're here by our lonesome to make sure Hometown Cable has this on video for future generations to enjoy. All right, first stop of the game by Matt Kendall. The Yellow Jackets, from what we have heard, got here with a victory over Brushton Moira. The Panthers beating the Panthers in penalty kicks. Went to a tie and the shootout decided it. And we've also heard that the Yellow Jackets are actually a Class D school, but they decided to defend their Class C title. Well, I'm wondering if maybe the possibility of having to go up against Shazy at the Class D level prompted the Yellow Jackets to say, let's play at the Class C level. If we win, then we won't have to face Shazy. Ball was quickly inbounded. It'd be a blue throw this time. Very pleasant day. Temperature approached 60, probably hit 60 in some places. In the high 50s as we arrived. So, unusually mild Election Day 2011. A lot of interesting local races that we'll be anxious to find out about when the dust settles here. We've got two games to cover on Hometown Cable. Also, the Class B's will be following this one as we're recording this. That'll be Beekman Town against, I can't remember who, but I will find out when I do that game. Bobcats went to the Final Four last year, I believe. Not last year, than the year before. They've won a bunch of titles in a row. Oh, I recall who Beekman Town will be playing. It's Salmon River. Salmon River, I think the last time we saw them in regional competition, it might have been in against Seton Catholic a few years back, and they were Class C then. Headed to Musso. Musso fires it out. Bobcat fans are excited about all that. Looks like Miller over to Trudeau, maybe. Can't always get a number on these guys until they turn their back, and then by the time they turn their back, somebody else has the ball. That was number 9. That's Kellett. Yep. That's Kellett. Call goes against the Yellow Jackets. Cats will put it in play. Looks like Labarge taking the kick. Trudeau giving chase. He'll take the throw. his foot and keeps it in play. And grabbed by Kendall. Outside of maybe one game. No, I guess they didn't even play here during the season. Thinking the Cats might have played here during the season, but because they're Division II and the Hornets are Division I, they may not have played a game, unless it was an extra game. So this is the Bobcats' possibly first trip here to the Plattsburgh High School field this year. The Bobcats had a first round bye, so they didn't play the semi. The finals was played at El Sable Valley. Quickly thrown in by the Jackets. There's Kellett. Who we got here? Miller? Yeah, that's Miller. Taken away by Madrid Waddington. Now kicked back by Rabideau. Whoa! Trudeau goes flying sideways. And the Yellow Jackets keep control. That were to Trudeau. Trudeau passes back. That's kicked forward, and it's going to be picked up by the keeper, Kendall. Takes his time. We have 32:50 to go in the opening half. LaBarge and Miller giving chase, and who we got here? Three is Mannion. Bicycle kick. Jackets will take a throw. Mayette will take the corner kick for the Jackets. Here come the... Oh. We'll try it again. No. Yep, here we go. Here come the Cats. Intercepted at midfield. Mannion sends it deep. Let's see, who's got the headband? That's Kellett. Two Kelletts. Kicked by Miller. Oh, deflects. Deflected off the head of Rabideau. Against the Jackets. Bobcat kick. Kellett will take the throw. Into the box. Out by the six. Quickly thrown in by LaBarge. Ferguson to take this corner. Somehow they're right up in today's Press Republican, called him Noah instead of Nolan. Oh, Cats almost snuck one in there, but the Yellow Jackets dodged the bullet. .28-15 in the first half. No score. Regional soccer. Kellett will take the throw. Tries to go up the wing. Rabbit was there. Kicked away by the Jackets. Kellett tries to slide a low ball in. Corner kick. Ball placed in front. Kendall's down. The Cats not charging. Trudeau over to take the corner kick. We're at 27 minutes showing. Blocked by the Yellow Jackets. Jackets keep it in play. And the ball is taken away by Miller. Lobs it up to the 18. And Madrid Waddington will carry it out. Kellett crosses it. Northeastern Clinton went and scheduled their sports awards for tonight, so I'm going to miss that. I don't often miss their sports awards, but they have to cooperate a little bit and schedule them when more reasonable chance of me being there. There's except for tonight, the rest of the week has no games scheduled until Saturday, just till Tuesday. There's blue throw. We're at 24-40 in the first half. Thrown in by the Jackets. LaBarge. Honan will take the goal kick for the Cats. Sent up the wing, up the middle. Garen charging in. Looks like there was an infraction there. It's not a goal kick because it's not on the 6-yard line. Honan back. Kicked out of bounds by Rabideau. This one's going to be in the stands, or close to it. But they just happened to have another ball right there, so they immediately threw it in. Blue throw. Honan, no high kick. A home guest, is all it says up there. We have seen some of the score keepers who are more familiar with the clock put up the actual team names, but if you're not familiar with the clock, it's a little easier to stick with the home and away. There's Rabideau working for it. The wing, and will they get there? Nope. Blue throw deep in battered Waddington territory. Handball. No, play on. Look, that ball has a mind of its own. The Cats take it away momentarily. Rabideau throws it in. Miller taking off the ball. This is Ferguson. Oh, Miller with a low shot. Oh, almost squirted up on Kendall. He'll take his time. Call one against the Bobcats. 15, let's see if we can get a quick name on him. James Hunt. James Hunt. That's a blue throw. 18-08 showing in the first half. 0-0 on the scoreboard. Throw goes down the side of the penalty area. Kicked out of bounds by LaBarge. Here's a corner kick. Handled easily by Musso. 17-15 showing in the first half. Section 7, Section 10, regional competition at the Class C level for 2011. Call one against the Jackets. Ferguson, I think. There's the punt. Comes to exactly midfield. Jackets take it away. And Cats get it back. Garen works it to the wing. Ferguson sends it up to the 18, headed. And the Jackets will keep it in play. Miller up to Nichols with the head. Garen gets a foot on it. Nichols with the body. Ferguson will put it in play as we approach the 15-minute mark. Headed out of the 18. Looks like Honan was up on the right wing for some reason instead of being back. We've got Mannion back with him. Here's the throw. Lobbed forward. Pellet sends it up to the six. Cleared out by the Jackets. Now Miller keeps it in play in the corner. Kellett will take the corner kick. Randy Lozier in the middle. Official, Gary Kaiser and Barry Norton, the flagman. Down to 13-15. There are two girls' games going on in section 10. Same time as this is going on. So Lake Placid representing section 7 against Tupper Lake. And then the B's, it's the same combination as the boys, Beekmantown and Salmon River. Call one against the Cats. Yellow Jackets will put it in play near midfield. Up the wing. He'll take the throw. Miller over. Miller lobs it into the penalty area, kicked by Trudeau, picked up by Kendall. Doesn't look like there's any breeze at all down on the field. You were watching the flag during the anthem, just hanging there. The corner flags are just hanging there, so calm night, mild night. And a dry night. Ooh, better get his brakes checked. Better get his brakes checked. I think he had time to slow down or at least change directions a little bit. Kick sends it up. Less than 10 to go in the first half, still scoreless. Kellett will take the throw. That one off the foot of Smart is a goal kick. Have a sub coming in Ferguson back in. There we go. Throw for Kellett. That's kicked deep. Honan is back. Blue throw. It's LaBarge over in or two. Ferguson to Miller. There's Trudeau. Rabideau throws it in. Trudeau. Viewer supported local television. If you're watching this and need your support, nobody is paying us to be here. Nobody paid us to go to Sable Valley for the sectional finals. Nobody pays us when we run up to Ellenburg for any of their home events. And it's a expensive proposition just for the gas alone without trying to make a living out of this. We need more Bobcat fans to step up, and those of you who do step up, ask the others why they're not helping out. We're trying to be fair to... Trudeau goes down hard. And no card. No card. No card on that one. The Bobcat fans are wondering why. And so is Peter Kowalowski. Oh, ball didn't get as far as I thought it was going to get. Ferguson trying to keep it alive. He goes down. 6 minutes to go in the half. It's going to be a blue kick. Ferguson throws. Ball comes to midfield. Trudeau keeps it in. LaBarge passes back to Honan. Ball comes to the 18. Cats are there again. Rabideau sends it to the P. Kicked by Mannion. As we were saying, this is viewer-supported local television, and we certainly need more of you to step up if you're Bobcat fans. And let us know that we're not doing this for nothing here, that you people appreciate what we're doing enough to support it. White throw. The Cats. About 3 minutes to go in the first half, still scoreless. Ferguson will take the throw. Miller kicks back. Honan sends it deep. There's Miller. on the barge. Like you didn't want Miller to touch it. There's Miller. Squirts all the way into Kendall.
Two-minute
warning. Kick near midfield. Headed at the 18. Sent deep. Headed right back. All of a sudden the Yellow Jackets are putting some pressure on. Headed out by Honan. We're at 52 seconds. There's a corner. Musso's got a call for those. He's trying to swat it or catch it, and there's a bobcat head in front of him. Jackets looking for a late goal here in the first half. Honan with the kick. 5 seconds. First half is going to end with the score. Northern Adirondack, nothing. Whoop, easy there. And Mr. Guerin, Northern Adirondack, nothing. And Madrid Waddington, nothing. You're watching viewer supported hometown cable TV worth your support. Second half is just underway. Section 7, Section 10, Regional Class C Soccer on Hometown Cable. Picked up by Musso. We'll have to get our tripod legs set up again here. November 8th, Election Day 2011. And whoop, whoa. It sure looked like he kicked it back. Looks like he tipped it back to the keeper here. That's a no-no. Gary Kaiser was right there. He didn't stick his flag up. He's a lineman, but I think he can indicate things like that. Kellett kicks it forward, taken by the Yellow Jackets. No score. Winner goes to the next stage, which might just be the final four. Not sure if there's another round here. It's possible that there's another round at Section 2 on Saturday. There's Ferguson. Sends it up to Kellett. Kellett sends it up to the six. So just a hair off is Trudeau. Cats keeping the pressure on. Oh! Like Mr. LaBarge didn't like that. He got the call. Stop the clock. I don't know if he was talking to Mr. Kowalski or Mr. Kelleher. One of them was told to not complain. Ferguson will take the throw. There's Miller. Up to the 18. Clear it out. Ferguson brings it back. There's Kella. He goes down. Blue throw. Back to Honan. We'll do Rabideau from Miller. Rabideau sends it up. Miller back to Rabideau. Headed by Kellett. And Kendall comes out to get it. 35 minutes to go in the second half. Nobody has scored as of yet. Very often, far too often, these games end up going into overtime and shootouts and stuff like that. Put in front of the net, and off the head and out. I'm looking for my roster sheet here. They put the ball back in play. That was Marcellus. Almost got a header. Here's a blue throw. Cat ball. Injured player on the blue team. Hazer came in for the Bobcats. Rabideau. There's Pazer. Sends it down and out. And it's a blue throw. Down the midfield, by the Jackets. Comes Madrid Waddington, stopped by Pazer. Pazer working hard. Going to be called for the push. Will be a blue kick, about 25 yard line. O'Brien almost getting a head on it. 31-17. Slow restart here. Honan takes it. Ferguson. Throw comes to Kellett. Ball deep. Alden kind of protecting the ball there. Didn't want that poor ball to get kicked, so he's kind of protecting it. Nice of him to think of the ball. Smart gets the call as Tiernan goes underneath him. Smart. White throw. Goes against Smart and Tiernan gets the call. Pass. Yellow Jackets keep control. Blue throw. Kellett able to get it off a Yellow Jacket. Another throw here for Justin Kellett. Nine is Scott Kellett. Ball kick near midfield. 27 minutes. We've played 53 and still nothing on the scoreboard. Hard to get the ball, but Yellow Jackets get it. There's Rabideau. Trudeau. Miller. Five, 20 left in the second half.
You tell him, Lisa!
Pager will take this throw. We had two Nichols, a Garand, and a Ferguson coming in for the Cats. White throw. Miller will take the corner. Over the top. Looks like some Eagles arriving here. Beekmantown Eagles. White throw. But it was a throw into Miller. Nichols. Nichols got that call. Here's a quick shot. It's just stopped by Kendall. A diving, sliding stop by the Yellow Jacket keeper, Matt Kendall. Blue throw. Subs were still coming off. Calling against the Bobcats. And it'll be a restart. Wide of the 18. A corner kick this time. One goal will probably be enough for whoever should score. There's a goal kick. Comes to midfield. At the midway point, 20 minutes gone and 20 minutes showing here in the second half. Nothing across in the first hour of this game. Blue throw. Whoa, instead of grabbing it. Another blue throw. It looked like Musso could have grabbed that first throw in there, but apparently didn't feel comfortable doing so. Corner kicks that the Yellow Jackets take. Greater the odds that they're going to put one across. And they're going to take yet another one. These are all great scoring opportunities. There's the goal kick. Yellow Jackets bring it right back. Headed at the 18. Broken up by Honan, but it's another corner kick. Did not deflect off blue, apparently. Call went against number five. It looks like it would be O'Brien. Jackets bring it back. Thank you. yet another corner kick for the Yellow Jackets. Only so many times that the Bobcats are going to dodge the bullet there. Musso made that stop. If the Yellow Jackets continue to have corner kicks, just a matter of time till they get something across. Kellett runs through the ball. Here's a shot. It's going to go way high and wide. I believe that was Miller taking the shot. There's a goal kick taken by Kendall. Fazer sends it up to about the 25-yard line. Headed by Trudeau. Now Rabideau. Under 14 minutes remaining in the half. Kicked by Honan. Call one against the Bobcats. Yellow Jackets will put it in play. Honan kicks it off on Madrid Waddington player. Now Pazer puts it in the air. Ferguson trying to get in there to steal it. Ferguson up to Kellett. Too far, he's not going to catch it. There's a goal kick. Ball at midfield. Ferguson got the call. Kellett on the wing. Crosses it. Nobody jumping on the cat side. Like they lost their wings there. Nobody jumping for the Cats. That was a headable service there. There's the goal kick. Daisy got a foot in there. And there's Trudeau. Ends it up the wing. Back into the box. It's Rabideau on the far side for the Cats. Here's Pazer. Yellow Jackets. Able to protect the ball. Grab. And kicked out. Deep into Madrid Waddington territory. We have less than 10 to go. About 9.5 showing. Thank you. is a punt. Jackets bring it back. Headed by Kellett. Miller chased it out of bounds. 8:21 showing. For Kellett. Kellett sends it up near the 18. And Jackets clear it out. Seven and a half to go. Before overtime. Blue throw. Matt had an opportunity there for the Yellow Jackets, but kicks it high and away. Down to 6:48. To the 18. As we said earlier, one goal is all it's going to take in this one. And we're hoping this one ends in regulation. Be a push just outside the box. What do you ask for 10? He's got about 6 yards right there. It's easy to figure out where the 10 is. Randy shouldn't have to count it. He got it off. He can just point to the yard line. There you go. Hey, Randy's seen a football game before. So the shot kick is low. Golden opportunity there for Madrid Waddington, but they couldn't capitalize. Under 5 to go in regulation. Blue throw. This time it'll be a blue throw. Down to 4:07. Fazer kicked it into the corner and knocked the flag down, and it's going to be a throw. It's going to be a throw, not a corner kick. Bobcat corner kick. Bobby! 2:45 left in the regulation. Deflects and just goes wide. It'll be a corner. Not much time left in regulation. Corner kick for the Cats. Kendall comes high. Make no mistake about that one. We're down to 2:02 in the second half. Late throw, 1:30 to go. Trudeau can't keep it in. As much as I hate to be the one to say it, it's starting to look a lot like overtime. Seconds. Waddington Yellow Jackets have scored, and this game is all but over. Defending regional champion Bobcats have been eliminated. And the Yellow Jackets will advance to the next round with a dramatic goal off a corner kick. They took a pile of corner kicks and they finally got one in, and that's all it took. And they will advance to the next round. So Madrid Waddington beats the Northern Adirondack Bobcats, and that's the way it was in Section 7, Section 10, Regional Class C Soccer on Election Day, November 8th, 2011. You've been watching viewer-supported local television hometown cable. TV worth your support.
This closing session, 10, Salmon River, Shamrocks.